in the flesh. How well did that work for the children of Israel in the Old Testament? It didn't. God gave Moses the law on Mount Sinai. The law was something that was spiritual. But the Israelites tried to fulfill it in the flesh because the Holy Ghost was not yet given. And how often did they succeed in fulfilling the law? They couldn't fulfill the law. They were trying to do something in the flesh, through the flesh, to fulfill something that was spiritual. It wasn't possible. And time and time and time again, they failed. Did people go to paradise? Yes, they went to paradise because of their faith. They were waiting for Christ. But were they able to fulfill the law? Absolutely not. None of them could fulfill the law because they had to try to do it and fulfill something spiritual in the flesh. It wasn't possible. And we all know that Jesus came not to do away with the law, but he was the fulfillment of the law. He was the one which the law pointed to. So it was not possible, and it still is not possible, to do spiritual things in our flesh, to fulfill them. God's armor is spiritual, and it does not bring judgment. It is there for our protection. What does Romans chapter 8, verse 1 state? Romans 8, 1. Someone else find 1 Corinthians 1, 10. And I'll find 2 Corinthians 13, 11. So Romans 8, 1. 1 Corinthians 1:10.
There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
There is therefore now no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus, who walk how?
Not after the flesh,
but after the Spirit. What about 1 Corinthians 1:10? That they would be perfectly joined together in the same mind and the same judgment. Is that they're all joined together in the same fleshly mind? No, it's the same spiritual mind. It's the same way as it was in the upper room in Acts chapter 2. We find that they were all in one mindset, in one accord. It was spiritual, not fleshly. 2 Corinthians chapter 10, 2 Corinthians chapter 13, and verse 11. Finally, brethren, farewell. Be perfect, be of good comfort, be of one mind. Live in peace, and the God of love and peace shall be with you. Once again, be of one mind, one spiritual mind, one mind to do the work of God. Not that we fulfill things in the flesh, but that we get the mind of God. And getting the mind of God is something spiritual. We may use the flesh through prayer, but prayer is something that's spiritual. When we get the same spiritual mindset of God and not do things through the flesh. People try to appease God through the flesh. And people can be in the flesh and try to get the mindset of God. But it doesn't work. If you're in the flesh, if you're carnal, you're not sure what's the mind of God, what's your own mind, and what's the mind of the enemy sometimes. They can easily get intertwined. Unless you compare it with Scripture, then it might be a little bit more distinctive, but still, if you get your voice in there, it might get a little confusing. But the more we draw close to God, the more we build up the spiritual man, we're going to know clearly the voice of God. What did he say? My sheep know my voice. And when we get into that mindset where we can know the voice of God, it makes all the difference. Because God's armor does not bring judgment for us, but is there for our protection. God's helmet and our armor is for our salvation. And I'd even go as far to even include our sanctification as well. What does Romans chapter 12 and verse 2 say? Romans 12, 2. Not conformed to this world. What's this world? Fleshly. But be transformed by the renewing of your mind, which is something spiritual. We find in Romans chapter 8 and verse 1, the Bible states, and I can probably quote it, I just don't want to get it wrong. There's therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, heart, but after the Spirit. And then in Philippians chapter 2, verse 5, if I remember correctly, it states, and let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. What is that? It is pointing us and showing us that the weapons of our warfare are truly not carnal or fleshly, but they're spiritual, and they're mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. If we are going to become a Pentecostal powerhouse, is going to be once we realize that we have to push past this flesh and grow in the Spirit. Let the Holy Ghost guide us, direct us, get these old worldly carnal thoughts out of our minds, subdued, and get our minds focused on Christ Jesus. Push past the flesh and build up the spiritual. You cannot perform the spiritual in the flesh. We have too many preachers nowadays trying to do exactly that, and they are leading people astray. Why? Because they're preaching a feel-good message, because they don't know what it is to get a hold of God and get the message for themselves. And through charisma, they are leading the people astray. They're making them feel good, but they're not knowing what spiritual things are. They're not able to fulfill spiritual things because they don't know how to do it. Because everything they do is in the flesh. When it comes to the worship, it's all in the flesh. Now don't get me wrong, when we praise God, we lift our hands, we lift our voices. But it's our spirit reaching out to God through our flesh, manifesting itself through praise and worship. We're not trying to perform the spiritual in the flesh itself, just to feel good, despite what Victoria Holstein might believe. Anybody have any thoughts, any questions at this point? If not, let's bow our heads in prayer and prepare our hearts for service. Gracious Heavenly Father, we give you all praise and glory for everything you've done for us and shall continue to do. Lord, we thank you that you're God who reigns on high and that there's none like you, Lord. Even right now, we rebuke every attack of the enemy that should come our way. We pray that you set your angels at the four corners of the property, above and below, that no attack of the enemy may penetrate. I pray that our hearts and our minds will be in one mindset, one accord, that we may worship you in sincerity and truth, that the Holy Ghost may move, making himself visible if he so chooses, Lord. I pray, Lord, that you anoint the song leader and the musicians, Lord, as they lead us in the songs you have us to sing. Give them a special blessing as they praise you upon the string instruments and the vocal cords, Lord. Anoint the minister today, Lord, as pastor, as he brings forth the word today. Anoint his mind and his lips to bring forth the words you have us to hear. And anoint our minds and our hearts to receive the message, that they would be good soil for your word to follow, Lord, that we may remember it throughout the week. But even greater than that we would apply it to our hearts. We ask all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.